Welcome to the lectures on Surveying 2. In today's lecture, we will learn about curves. Types of curves. There are different types of curve. One is simple circular curve. Then we have compound curve. Then reverse curve. That is the transition curve. These four are generally classified as under horizontal curve. We have mainly two types of curve, the horizontal curve and the vertical curve. These four, that is simple circular curve, compound curve, reverse curve and the transition curve. These curves are generally known as the horizontal curves. And we have this, we can say under the category of one A, and the second one, that is the vertical curve. In this we have summit curve and valley curve. And the next one is valley curve. Summit curve and valley curve. So let's learn what is simple circular curve. The simple circular curve can be defined as a single curve or as a single curve of a circle whose radius is r. So what is means it is represented, it represents an arc that is a part of circle. So the radius of this arc or the radius of this curve, which is that radius will be equivalent to the radius of circle. Suppose this sphere in this circle and the radius of this circle is r, the radius of this circle is r, and we are taking a part of this circle, or we are taking an arc of this circle which is representing a curve whose radius is r, then that curve will be called a simple circular curve. This will be a simple circular curve. And the next is compound curve. So what is compound curve? The compound curve is two or more arc of a circle with the different two or more arc of the different circles. So the radius of these arcs will be different, as well as the center of the arc will be on the same side. So what we are saying, this is one arc of a circle center O. This, let's say that is R1. This is one arc of a circle whose radius is R1. Here can be, we can have one another curve. The radius of this curve is R2. So this is the compound curve. So What is compound curve? The compound curve can be defined as the two or more number of arc of the different circles. So this is the arc of one circle whose radius is r1, where this is the arc of some another circle whose radius is r2. So it consists of two or more. Here in case of this compound curve, we have two arc of the radius r1, r2. It may have more than two arc also. So the compound curve can be defined as which consists of two or more arc of the different circles. So as we are seeing different circles, the radius of this circle will be different. And another condition that the center of both this both the arc should be on the same side. This is the center of first curve. Right? This is center of, that's for this point as O1, and this is O2. This is the O1 is the center for curve 1, that is arc 1, and O2 is the center for arc number 2. So here O1 and O2 both are on the same side of the curve. This is the curve, this is the one of the side of the curve. Both the center, that O1 and O2, are on the same side. So this is the compound curve. Then we have next is reverse curve. What is reverse curve? The definition of the reverse curve is, the reverse curve can be defined as which has two or more arc of the same radius, or it may be with the different radius, but the center of these arcs should be in the opposite direction. What we are saying, it may have two or more arc, or it may have two or more curve of the same radius, or it may have with the different radius, but the center of these curves should be in opposite direction. So we can say this is one of the curve, while this is another curve. This is point O1, this is the radius R1, this is the radius R1, while this is another curve, center is O2. Here the radius, this may be R1, or this radius may be even R2 also. So what is what the radius, this is what the reverse curve. Here we can say this is one curve, this is another curve. It can have some more curve also, it can be further, it can continue like this also. So this is the reverse curve, which has two or more curves, two or more arc, which may be the radius of this arc or radius of this curve may be same or it may be different. Here this may be R1, this may also be R1. Here R1 may be equal to R2. This is the first one, or R1 may not be equal to R2. So the radius of these curves may be same or it may be different, but the point we should be remember here that this center of these curve will be in opposite direction. The O1 is in this direction, that is within the that is inside the curve, while this is the second center of this curve. If corresponding to this center is in outside the curve, means this is one side, it is here in this side, but then this curve is in opposite side. That is another condition, that this center of both the curve should be in opposite direction. This is the reverse curve. Then we have transition curve. Transition curve is a curve whose radius varies from infinite to the radius r. This is referring to the radius of circle. Suppose this is a simple circular curve whose radius is r. And the transition curve, suppose this point of tangency, this is the point of curvature, that's for t1, this is the point of tangency, that is point t2. So the tangent, generally the transition curve is introduced before beginning of circular curve, even after ending of circular curve. So this will be the transition curve, this will be the transition curve. Why we provide the transition curve, what is the purpose of providing this, we will learn by discussing the transition curve. But we introduce the transition curve before and after the curve. So then the radius of the transition curve varies from infinite to the radius of infinite to the radius which is equivalent to the radius of circular curve. At this point, the radius of curve will be, at this point, the radius of transition curve will be infinity. But at this point, the radius of this transition curve will be equivalent to the radius of this simple circular curve. So, the radius of transition curve varies from infinite to the radius r, which is the radius of simple circular curve. Then we have seen, so these are the horizontal curve. After this, we have discussing about the vertical curves. In the vertical curves, there are two, that is, number one is summit curve. What is summit curve? These are the curves with the convexity upward. This is the convexity upward. So these curves are, these are summit curve. While the valley curves are whose convexity is downward. These are the valley curves. So these are the different types of curve. We have learned the horizontal curve as well as the vertical curve. In the horizontal curve, we have seen the simple circular curve, then we have seen the compound curve, then we have seen the transition curve and the reverse curve. Well, in case of vertical curve, we have the summit curve and the valley curve. Now let's learn some of the definition or some of the terms which we will frequently use during this chapter, that is curve. So you see the first term, that is the point of commencement. This is also known as point of curvature. Generally we represent this point as PC, or we generally sometimes we write it as T1. This point is the point of curvature, that is T1, or the point of commencement. What is the point of commencement or point of curvature? It is the point at which the curve, at which the curve starts. This is the point from where the curve starts, or this is the point from where curve commences, or it is the point from where the curve begins. So the point from where the curve begins, the point from where the curve commences, that point is known as the point of curvature or the point of commencement. It is sometimes written as, it is denoted as T1. Well, the next we have, point of tangency. T2 or the PT. This is the point at which the curve ends. The point at which the curve ends, that is called the point of tangency. So this is the point of tangency where the curve is ending. Or this also represented as T2. Then we have back tangent.
and then point of intersection . This is the point of intersection. If we will extend, this is the point T1, that is point of commencement. If we will draw a tangent at this point T1, if a tangent will be drawn at the point T1 and it will be extended further, then that will be called a back tangent. If we will draw a tangent at this point T1 and if it is extended, then this extended line is this one. So this line or this line will be called as the back tangent. This point T2, this is the point of, this is the point where the curve ends, or this point where the curve finishes. So then the if a tangent will be drawn at this point and it will be forwarded, then that line will be called the forward tangent. If a tangent will be drawn at this point and this will be extended further, then this will be called the forward tangent. The forward tangent, and then we have the point of intersection. Which is the point of intersection? The back tangent and the forward tangent meets at a point, or the point at which the back tangent and the forward tangent intersect each other. That point is called the point of intersection. In this figure, this back tangent and this forward tangent intersect each other at this point. That's called this point as I. So the I will be called the point of intersection. The point where the back tangent and the forward tangent meet, or to say they intersect, that point is called point of intersection. So in this point I, this will be the point of intersection. Let's call this as I. Then we have the angle of intersection. So this will be the angle in between the back tangent and the forward tangent is called the angle of intersection. So this is the angle in between the back tangent and the forward tangent. So it is called, let's call this is theta. So theta is here, it's called the angle of intersection. Then next we have the angle of deflection. What is the angle of deflection? If the back tangent is extended further, if the back tangent is extended further, then the angle in between the back tangent and the forward tangent will be called the angle of deflection. Here, if we will extend this back tangent further and this is the forward tangent, then this angle in between the back tangent and the forward tangent will be called the angle of deflection. That's called this as alpha. In some of the cases, sometimes alpha has delta also. You can represent this by anyone, you can represent it by alpha, or you can represent it by delta also. So the angle of deflection is what? If the back tangent is extended further, then the angle in between the back tangent and the forward tangent is called the angle of deflection. Here we generally use the term alpha for the angle of deflection. So I am just mentioning that alpha. Then next we have the tangent distance. Tangent distance, it is the distance from the point of curvature or the point of commencement
to the point of intersection, that is the distance between the point of intersection and the point of curvature is called the back tangent. It is called the tangent distance. So this is the point from where the curve starts. This is the point of curvature and this is the point of intersection. So distance between this will be called the tangent distance. The tangent distance, right? We have the next term, where is the external distance? What is the external distance? The distance from the point of intersection to the curve. The distance from the distance between the point of intersection and the curve, that is called external distance. So this distance will be called the external distance. You can represent this external distance by the term E. Right, for this we use the term, for tangent distance we use the term T. You can use some other terminologies also. We are using this terminology and we will use this, you know, these terminologies only throughout this chapter. So we are representing here tangent distance by T, or external distance by E. After this we have some more definitions. We discuss the 8th point, that is the 9th, that is the length of the curve and then length of long chord. What is the length of the curve generally represented by small l? That is length of the curve, and capital L we use for the length of long curve. So what is the length of curve? The total distance, what is the total length of the curve in between the point of tangent, the point of curvature and the point of tangency is called the length of the curve. So what is the length of the curve? It is the total length of the curve in between the point of curvature and the point of tangency. So what is the total length of the curve? This is the total length of the curve in between. This is the total length of the curve in between the point of curvature and the point of tangency. So this will be called the length of the curve. Well, next is what? The length of long curve. This is the straight line. This is the distance. This is the direct distance, or this is the shortest distance between the point of curvature and point of tangency. Sometimes this is called, this is the length of the line. This is the length of the line joining the point of curvature and the point of tangency. The line which is joining the PC and PT will be this one. This is the straight line which is joining the T1 and T2. So this distance will be called the length of long chord. So this will be length of long chord. Then we have next term. Midordinate then we have right hand curve, then we have next is left hand curve. What is the midordinate? This is the center of, it is a line joining the center of curve to the long chord. This is the distance of the line joining the center point of the curve to the long chord. That is called midordinate. So this will be the midordinate that's represented by M. So this is the midordinate represented by M. What is this? This is the distance of, this is the distance of a line, or this is the line joining the center point of the curve to the long chord. So this is the midordinate. Then we have next the right hand curve, and then we have the left hand curve. If the curve is turning towards the right hand from the point of tangency, then it is called the right hand curve. here the case which we are discussing, in this the curve is drawn if you put the right hand side from the point of tangent, from the point of curvature. This is the point of curvature and it is turning towards the right hand side. So this particular curve will be called right hand curve. This is the right hand curve. While if the curve is turning towards the left hand from its point of curve, from its point of curvature, then this will be called the left hand curve. If suppose there is a point from where the curve is turning toward this side, then this curve will be called the left hand curve. So these are some of the definitions which we will use throughout this curve, throughout this chapter. Next one we have the degree of curve. We will define the degree of curve on the basis of two points, that is on the basis of one is the length of arc and the length of curve. On the basis of length of arc and the second point, that is length of curve. There are two points on the basis of length of arc and on the basis of length of curve, we define the degree of curve. How we define the length of the degree of curve on the basis of length of arc? Then we will say the degree of curve can be defined as the angle subtended by the angle subtended at the center by the length of by the arc of the length 30 meter. How we define it is the degree of curve can be defined as the angle subtended by the arc at the center of length 30 meter. Means if we will take an arc of length 30 meter, then angle subtended by this arc at the center of the curve will be defined as the degree of curve. While the length of curve, on the basis of this, the degree of curve can be defined as the angle subtended at the center of curve by a chord of length 30 meter. Then suppose this is the chord of 30 meter length, then the angle subtended by this chord at the center of curve will be the degree of curve. So if we take generally on the basis of this, the curve, the degree of curve is defined on the basis of length of arc in case of the curves are designed for railways, while the degree of curve is defined on the basis of this term, that is length of curve in case of when the curve need to be designed for the roadways, that is for the highway. So on the behalf of this definition, we will try to derive the degree of curve, or we will try to arrive at the degree of curve. Or we can say, suppose this is an arc, or this and chord of a circle whose radius is r, then we can say the circumference of curve of a circle is we know that it is 2 pi r. So the angle subtended on this 2 pi r, the angle subtended at the center of circle is 360 degrees. So the angle subtended from this 2 pi r at the center of circle is 360 degrees. So 1 unit will subtend the angle at the center of circle. This will be 360 divided by 2 pi r. So this will be, so the angle subtended due to 30 unit or 30 meter. Let's take it as 30 meter. Therefore, the angle subtended due to 30 meter at the center of the circle or at the center of the curve, it will be 360 divided by 2 pi r into 30. This is what? This will be the angle subtended at the center. So we can call it as d degree. So this will be what? This will be nothing but this will be the angle subtended at the center of curve. This will be length. This will be called the degree of curve. So if we will generalize this, we will get this d degree as, if we solve this 360 divided by 2 pi r into 30, we will get as 1718.9 divided by r. So this degree of curve is 1718.9 divided by r. If we will make, if you want to take 1 degree curve, for a 1 degree curve, the radius of curve will be equal to 1718.9 meter for 1 degree curve. After this, let's see some of the formulas for the elements of the curve. We have discussed so many elements of the curve in the form of definitions, like we have seen the length of rhomboid, length of curve, back tangent, tangent distance, point of curvature, that is point of commencement, and at last point of tangency also. So let's discuss some of the formulas for these terms, or to say for these elements. This length of curve we are representing using the small l. So we can calculate this length of curve using a formula that is small l equals to 2 pi r divided by 360 into the angle alpha. Alpha is what? Alpha is the angle of deflection. Alpha is nothing but the angle of deflection. Right, r is nothing but the radius of curve. This is the radius of curve, and l is nothing but the length of the curve. Second one, length of rhomboid. The length of rhomboid is represented by capital L. So capital L will be here 2r sine alpha by 2, where alpha is nothing but it is the angle of deflection. This is the point T1 in this curve. This is point T1, that is the point of curvature. This is the T2, that is point of tangency. This is the point I. This is the I, that is angle of, that is point of intersection. This will be the angle of deflection. Let's call this as alpha. Where this will be the angle of intersection. Let's call this as theta. This is the length of curve. This will be length of rhomboid. So this is the length of rhomboid, that is 2r sin alpha by 2. find the formula for this, calculating the tangent of curve, that is small l. This is nothing but 2 pi r divided by 360 into alpha. Now we are interested to calculate the tangent distance. Point of curvature to this point of intersection. This is called the tangent distance. So you can calculate this tangent distance as d equals to r tan alpha by 2, where alpha is angle of reflection and r is radius of curve. Next element, that is number 4, take it as a genus of point of curvature. Genus of point of curvature, this we can find out as genus of point of curvature, that is given as. How we find out this? The genus of point of intersection is known to us. The genus of point of intersection is known to us. Then we are, if it is known, then we are at this point. If we are at this point and we want to find out the genus of point of curvature, that is this point. So what you can do, if you are at this point, if I consider this tangent distance, then I reach at this point. So how I can write the formula for genus of point of curvature? This is the genus of point of intersection minus the tangent distance, that is d. If this tangent of point of intersection is known to us, if I am at this point and I want to reach at this point, so from this, if I deduct this one, if this much, if I come back of this equal, that is distance equivalent to d, I will get the tangent of point of curvature. So what I am doing, I am subtracting the distance t, that is tangent distance, from the point of intersection. So I am writing the same thing, the tangent of point of intersection minus the tangent distance. This will give me the tangent of point of curvature or the tangent of point of commencement. Next step, tangent of point of tangency. Now let's solve some of the numerical on this curve. This is the question number 1. We have two straight lines. What is given? Two straight intersection meets at the genus 1390 meter, and the angle of intersection is 144 degrees given. And we are asked, and the radius is also given, radius of the curve is also given as 100 meter, and we are asked to calculate this pi parameter, that is the tangent distance first of all, then the length of the curve, change of point of curvature, check as our point of tangency, and at last we are asked to find out the length of long chord. So let's write what is given first of all. Given is chain of intersection. Chain of I is given as 1390 meter. We are given the angle of intersection, means this is what given. This is given as 144 degree, but we need to find out this, the angle of deflection. So what is given? Theta is given as 144 degree. So we have to find out the angle of deflection, that is alpha. It will be 180 minus 144, so this will be 36 degree. Then what is given? The radius of curve is given, that is r equals to 100 meter. So this is what given to us. Now let's calculate the first one, that is tangent distance. So tangent distance is t, but this is the formula for tangent distance is r tan del alpha by 2. So r is given as 100 meter, tan 36 by 2. If we solve this, we will get the tangent distance t as 32.49 meters. Now let's calculate the second one. That is the length of the curve. We know the formula for the length of the curve is nothing but 2 pi r divided by 360 into alpha. So we will solve this. 2 pi into r is 100 divided by 360 into alpha, that is 36 degrees. So if we solve this, we will get the length of the curve as 62.83 meter. After this, third one, that is the changes of point of curvature, means we are asked to calculate the changes of point T1. This is the changes of point of curvature, this is the point curvature point. So changes of point of curvature is asked to find out. This will be the changes of point of intersection minus the tangent distance. The changes of point of intersection is already given as 1390 meters. So we take it 1390 minus the tangent distance, that is how much? 32.49, means the changes of this point is how much? 1390, and this is the tangent distance, that is 32.49. so what is the changes of this point? 1390 minus 32.49. if we do this, we will get it 1357.51 meter. Last one, that is the fourth one, that is we are asked to find out changes of point of tangency. This is the point of tangency T2. So changes of point of tangency, this will be the changes of point of curvature, that is T1, plus the length of the curve. The changes of point of tangency is 1357.51 plus length of the curve. We have already calculated it, 62.83. So we will add it. So the changes of point of tangency T2, this will be 1420.34 meters. Then the last one, so we have calculated this tangent distance, we have calculated the length of the curve, we have calculated the changes of curvature, we have also calculated the changes of point of tangency. Now the last one, that is the fifth, that is the length of long chord, that is capital L. The length of long chord, the formula for this is 2r sin alpha by 2. So
So this will root into R is 100 sine 36 by 2. We will do this, we will get the length of long chord, that is L. This will be 61.80 meter. This is the length of long chord. Now we will discuss how to set the simple circular curves. We have some of the methods for setting simple circular curve. We have some of the methods. Discuss the methods by which we can set a simple circular curve. The number one is by using chord method. Second, by using tangent method. Then the third, that is by using chord produced method. Then using the Rankine method. These methods are also called deflection Mendel method. More precisely, this can be known as single deflection angle method. This can be called as double deflection angle method. So these are some of the methods by which we can set the simple circular curve. Now let's discuss first of all the chord produced method. The first one is chord produced method. So how to discuss? We know the point of intersection is known to us, and after knowing this, whenever we will solve the problem, we will be knowing the radius of the curve will be known to us. The angle of intersection, that is the angle of deflection, will be known to us. These things will be known to us, as well as the genesis of point of intersection will also be known to us. So on the basis of this, we will start. We said we have to do certain calculation first of all, and after doing those calculation, we can set the simple circular curve. If we want to set a simple circular curve using the chord produced method, we have to do the calculation and we have to find out the length of, first of all, the length of subchord. Then we have to also calculate the length of normal chords. and corresponding to this the subchords and the normal chords we have to calculate the length of offsets. Generally we represent this by C, this also by C, and the length of offset by O. So we have to do certain calculations for this, and we have to ready with these calculations. We have to be ready with the number of subchords, that will be 2, and the number of normal chords, and as well as we have to also calculate the length of offset corresponding to this length of chords. And after that we can start setting this simple circular curve using this chord produce method. How to calculate this length of subchord and this length of normal chord offset, that we will discuss while solving the numerical on this. First we will, here we will discuss directly how to set this simple circular curve by using this chord produce method. As we are saying, this point of intersection is known to us, and by using the formula we can calculate the tangent distance. So we can set the point of curvature, that is point of commencement. Now from here onwards we want to set the curves. So what we do, as we are saying that length of subchord, let's say the length of subchord is C1, this is known to us, and corresponding to this the length of first offset is also known to us. So what we don't know in this direction, should I move in this direction, should I move in this direction, should I move in this direction, I don't know in this direction, shall I move. So what, how to decide the first point? The first point on the curve is very important, because that will give us, because the first point of the curve will give us the direction in which we can move on the curve. So that is very important. So how to set the first point on the curve? We know the length of first subchord is known to us, that is C1. So what we will do with the using chain, we will set the first point on this, that is back tangent. So on this we will make an arc, and we will cut an arc equivalent to the C1 on the back tangent. So this is the point what we got on the back tangent. Here still we didn't get the point on the curve. Similarly, this will be this arc equivalent to C1 will be cut by keeping the arrow on the point of curvature. This will be cut here at this point. Now we will make one more arc equivalent to the distance C1 from this point T1, and let's say this is cut at this point. Here another point, another person who will be standing at this point. Let's call this point as small p. This person will cut an arc that is equivalent to the offset O1. And this, and the intersection of this point, of these two arcs, will give us the first point on the curve. So this distance will be equal to O1, while this distance will be equal to C1. So what we are doing, we have cut an arc equal to C1 somewhere in between here, and another C1 on this back tangent. So we got this point. Then another person who is standing at this point, he will cut one more arc that is equal to the length of first offset O1. So the intersection of these two arcs will give us the first point on the curve. So this is the first point on the curve. From here onwards, what we will do, we will extend this as a line of sight. From here, now this is the first point on the curve. Let's call this as point A. Now how to get the point, second point on the curve? From here also we will cut an arc equivalent to the distance C2 on this line of sight. Let's call this distance is equivalent to the C2, and one more arc will be cut in this curve area from this point A equivalent to C2. Let's call this is cut somewhere here. Then one more person who is standing at this point, he will cut an arc equivalent to the offset distance O2. He will cut an arc from this point equivalent to O2. So this is the second point on the curve B. How to get now the third curve on the curve? Just AB, the line of this line of sight will be extended further. Then from here we will make an arc equivalent to the C3 on this line of sight. Similarly, we will cut one more arc in this curve area, and the person who is standing at this point, he will cut an arc equivalent to the offset O3. Let's cut, this point is cut somewhere here, so this will be the third point on the curve. Similarly, we will join all these curves. This will be similarly, this can be proceed further in a similar way. To get the fourth point, what we will do, we will extend this line of sight further. And again, we will cut tend an arc equivalent to C4 somewhere here, an arc equivalent to C4, then we will cut an arc equivalent to offset 4 from this point. Then we cut somewhere, let's call this point as G1. So these will be, this is over, this distance will be equivalent to O2, this distance will be equivalent to O3, this distance will be equivalent to O4. So like this we can move further and we can create a simple circular curve using this water reduced method. This is the point of intersection, this is the point of curvature T1. This, obviously this point of intersection will be known to us by using the calculation, we can find out the tangent distance. So we will reach at the point of curvature. Here also, before starting the setting simple circular curve using this Rankine method, we have to do certain calculation. We have to calculate the reflection angle of the chord. Let's call the reflection angle of the chord is L1. Or let's represent del n. This can be calculated using the formula 1718.9 cm divided by r. Using this formula, we can calculate the deflection angle of the chord. If you want to calculate delta 1, this will be 1718.9 into c1 divided by r. Similarly, delta 2 will be 1718.9 into C2 by R. If similarly you want to calculate, then and this will be 1718.9 into C10 divided by R. So corresponding to the support, we can get the length of deflection angle. Corresponding to first support, there will be deflection angle. Corresponding to second normal support, there will be deflection angle. Similarly, by using this formula, you can calculate the deflection angles of the chord. Before setting up, we have to be ready with this calculation. After that, we can start setting simple circular curve using this Rankine method. So, what we have to do? We have to station, we have to keep a theodolite at this point T1, which will be sighted towards the point of intersection. We have already calculated the deflection angle L1 of the chord. So, the theodolite which is kept here, that will be moved in a horizontal plane for an angle equivalent to L1. That's why this is the angle delta 1. Corresponding to this line of sight, now after this we will be knowing already the length of first sub chord, that is C1. Now we got the line of sight. This is the line of sight after moving the theodolite equivalent to L1 angle. So this is the line of sight. Now we already know the length of first sub chord, that is C1. So we will put an arrow here and we will cut an arc equivalent to C1. Let's call this is the first here. The arc cut at this point, the line of sight. So this will be the first point on the curve. Let's call this as A1. So this what? The A1 is the first point on the curve. Now how to get the second point on the curve? The theodolite will remain at this point T1 only throughout setting of this curve. Now here, after this, we calculate the delta 2 also. So now, the theodolite will move again in horizontal angle for the deflection angle equivalent to delta 2. So this is the angle delta 2. So this is the line of sight on which we will get the second point on the curve. We already know the length of normal chord, that is C2. We will put an arrow here and we will cut an arc that is equivalent to C2. Let's call this has been cut somewhere here. So this will be the second point on the curve, T1. Similarly, again we will move to an angle delta 3 and then we will get the third point similarly C. Then again we will get some more points. By lowering these points, we can get the curve, simple circular curve. something like this, we can get this curve using Rankine method. Then the last one is two dotted line method. What we will do in this two dotted line method? We have to be ready with the calculations, that is similar to del 1, del 2, del 3. We have to be ready with all this angle calculations. In this, this will be the point of curvature at this T1. That's what this is the point T2, that is the point of tangency. In this method, we have to use two dotted line method, as it is already clear from the name itself, it is two dotted line method. So we have to use two dotted line. One dotted line will be stationed at this point, another dotted line will be stationed at this point. This, the line joining this T1 and T2, this will be the long curve. The third line which is stationed at this point T1, that will be sighted towards the point of intersection. This is the point of intersection. And the third line number 2, which is stationed at this point of tangency, that will be sighted towards the point of curvature. From here, we have already calculated the deflection angles, that is del 1, deflection angles of the chord, that is del 1, del 2, del 3, and so on. The third line number 1, which is sighted towards the point of intersection, will be moved in a horizontal plane equivalent to deflection angle del 1. So we will get some line of sight here. So this, let's say this is equivalent to del 1. After this, the third line number 2, which is sighted towards the point of curvature, will also move in a horizontal plane equivalent to angle of deflection del 1. So this is also, let's call this is also equivalent to del 1. So the intersection of each line of sight will give us the first point on the curve, that is called this point A. After this, third line number 1, which is at point of the curvature, this will again move in the horizontal plane equivalent to the angle del 2. Similarly, the third line number 2, which is stationed at the point T2, will also move in the horizontal angle equivalent to deflection angle delta 2. Let's call this is delta 2. So the intersection of this will give us the second point on the curve. Similarly, again this will be moved for angle delta 3. So this will be delta 3. This will give us the third point on the curve. So like this we can get the points on the curve. By joining these points, you can get the simple circular curve. So this will be two third line method. So in today's lecture, we have learned about the curves. We have started from the type of curve. We have seen two types of the curve, horizontal curve and the vertical curve. In the horizontal curve, we have seen the simple circular curve, then compound curve, reverse curve and the transition curve. Under the vertical curve, we have discussed summit curve as well as vertical curve. Then we discussed some terminologies related to curve. Then we learned about degree of curve. We have solved some of the element. We have seen the formulas related to the curve, then we discussed, then we have solved the numerical on the curve regarding the calculation of elements of the curve, then we discussed the methods of setting up a simple circular curve. Thank you.